What up, guys? My name's Alex Rome, and I'm gonna make a simple beat in Logic Pro X. I don't know where this is gonna go, but it's gonna go, I can tell you that. So I'm gonna click on the library tool up here, and then I'm gonna come down to piano. Depending on what kind of or what version of Logic Pro X you have, you may or may not have all these pianos. You may have the Steinway Grand if you don't have the version I have. So I'm just gonna pick Steinway Grand anyway. Even though I would pick the Yamaha because I think it sounds a little nicer. Whatever, maybe I'm just used to the Steinway. So what I did is I picked a secondary tool called the pencil tool and I held command and clicked in a region. I'm gonna make this beat at 80 beats per minute. And let's put down some chord. Too low for me. So let's try this. Okay, let's compress our piano. Oh, that sounds nice. The vintage VCA. I never actually tried that. And let's go and lay down some drums now because what's a beat without drums, right? So I'm gonna use. Oh yeah, I'm trying to get used to explaining everything I do. So I clicked on this instrument tab here where it usually says instrument here, like right now. And then you click on those arrows and drag down to Ultra Beat Drum Synth. And then my favorite kit is the Hit Machine. And let's get this going with a kick drum, which is on C1. Gonna split these up. I'm gonna do kick on one layer and then drum on the other, or snare on the other. Let's get the snare going. Right, let's see if we can do something cool. Cool. Sounds like it works to me. You know what? Not feeling leads right now. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to add some leads later. So let's just get some nice simple hi-hats like tss. Nothing crazy. We kind of want to stay with the pace of the beat, you know? Because drums really drive how fast the song is moving and how fast it feels. So you really want to you don't want to overwork the drums. So just keep something simple for now. Don't like this extra kick. Okay, so now let's add some bass because what's a beat without bass? Nah, tutorial settings, analog bass, and then we're going to take this up to the sine wave here. And we're gonna loosen up the attack a little bit because this gets pretty poppy. It does this little thing that I don't want it to do. Let's get this and off. Let's get this off. Let's get this off. Then let's distort it little more. That's not much distortion. Oh, it's because. What's going on? Oh, just a little bit of a lag. Still a little bit distorted. More than I wanted. Okay, so now let's split this up. Maybe two rounds of piano, and then we'll drop the drums and the bass. And then we could do like four of these. And on the second half, let's add some cellos because cellos are my favorite. Let's add some reverb. These buses are defaulted to reverb. Let's see how this sounds. Need to leave a little bit of a space there, and I'm thinking maybe some trem to mix it up a little bit. That's a little too much. I wanted to do one over here and then go over here, do another. Come on, that sounds awesome. All right, so let's hear what we got. Sounds good to me, guys. What do you think? Leave your answer in the comments. Let me know what you think about that simple beat using Logic Pro instruments. And I hope you learned something. Because my name is Alex Rome, and come subscribe to me. And I'll see you later.